the Moon, Earth's only natural satellite and fifth largest of its kind in our solar system. At night, it's the brightest object for Earthlings due to the reflection of sunlight. It's the reason behind the tides in our oceans and eclipses. But can we replace the Moon with something else and expect the same behavior? Will the Earth's rotation and inclination change? Let's speculate about what would happen if a black hole replaced the Moon in today's video of DiscoverZen. The Moon is orbiting the planet Earth of the inner solar system. As Earth's only natural satellite, its surface gravity is about 1/6 of Earth's with 0.1654g. Moon's escape velocity is 2.38 kilometers per second. That is much less than the 11.2 kilometers per second it takes to get off of Earth. And this is the reason why NASA and other companies are interested in building a permanent moon base to further explore the cosmos. On average, the Moon's orbital distance to Earth is 384,402 kilometers, or 238,856 miles. That is about 30 times the diameter of Earth. Its gravitational pull provides tides on Earth, possibly helping the planet's magnetic field and slight lengthening of the day. The Moon is in a tidal lock synchronous rotation with Earth, rotating on its axis as fast as it orbits the Earth, thus always showing the same side to the blue planet, though slightly more than half, about 59% of the total lunar surface can be viewed from the planet because of libration. The apparent size in Earth's sky is almost the same as that of the Sun, since the star is about 400 times the lunar distance and diameter. Therefore, the Moon covers the Sun nearly precisely during the total solar eclipse. This matching of apparent visual size will not continue in the far future, because the Moon's distance from Earth is gradually increasing. Yes, you heard that right. The Moon is getting farther away by 1.5 inches or 3.8 centimeters every year. There are many theories with different explanations for the formation of the Moon, but the most widely accepted today is the giant impact theory. It proposes that the Moon formed during a collision between Earth and another small planet about the size of Mars. The debris from this impact collected in an orbit around Earth to form the Moon. Before moving further, let's see some properties of a black hole so that it's going to be easier to compare. A black hole is a region of space-time where gravity is so strong that nothing, no particles, not even electromagnetic radiation such as light, can escape from it. The theory of general relativity predicts that a sufficiently compact mass can deform space-time to form a black hole. Every black hole has something called event horizon. This is the boundary of a region from which no escape is possible. Generally, black holes are made when the center of a very big star falls upon itself or collapses. When this happens, it causes a supernova. A supernova is an exploding star that blasts part of the star into space. So, how do we detect these monsters? Scientists can't directly observe black holes with telescopes that detect X-rays, light, or other forms of electromagnetic radiation because of the far distances. We can, however, infer the presence of a black hole and study them by detecting their effect on other matter nearby. For example, if a black hole passes through a cloud of interstellar matter, it will draw inward in a process known as accretion. A similar process can occur if a normal star passes close to the black hole. In this case, the black hole can tear a star apart as it pulls it in. As attracted matter accelerates and heats up, it emits X-rays that radiate into space. Recent discoveries offer some tantalizing evidence that black holes have dramatic influences on the neighborhoods around them, emitting powerful gamma ray bursts, devouring nearby stars, and spurring the growth of new stars in some areas while stalling it in others. To know more about black holes, watch our video on What If We Visit a Black Hole, link in the description. Now let's remove our Moon and replace it with a black hole of the same mass in the orbit. What would happen? Well, nothing much. Sure, we would lose the light. Every night would be a moonless night, but the gravitational field would be exactly the same. Tides would still exist. The black hole would continue to play the same role in the dynamics of the Earth-Moon system as it does now, including the stabilization effect of the Earth's axis of rotation. Since a black hole with the mass of our moon will be extremely tiny, we will never see a solar or lunar eclipse. As to the black hole itself, it would be harmless unless you got really close. It would be a tiny black hole because its Schwarzschild radius would be a mere 0.1 millimeters. The Schwarzschild radius is the radius of the event horizon surrounding a non-rotating black hole, as any object with a physical radius smaller than its Schwarzschild radius will be a black hole. The Hawking temperature will be lesser than that of the cosmic microwave background, so its Hawking radiation would be absolutely negligible, and it would be soaking up more microwave radiation than it loses, so it would ever so slowly grow. And only if you got within a few kilometers of this black hole, its tidal forces become strong enough to become dangerous. In fact, such a tiny black hole in Earth's orbit would represent a tremendous opportunity to study extreme gravitational fields. But a black hole of this size has never been discovered in the universe. Theoretically, it's possible, but practically, we'll never find one. Anyway, scientists are still studying the right conditions to coexist for the black hole formation. Now let's spice things up a bit. Let's replace the black hole with one the size of our moon. This won't be good for the Earth or even our solar system. In this case, the mass of our moon will be around 588 suns. This is actually having more gravitational pull than even our own star, the Sun. Thinking about tides, solar eclipses, and tilting of Earth would be the least of our concerns in this scenario, as this kind of black hole will suck in the Earth almost immediately. Then slowly, it will start posing threat to other planets too. Venus, Mars, etc. Slowly, this giant black hole will suck our whole solar system. No Earth, no planet, no life, no solar system. Now we know that replacing the moon with a black hole is not a good idea. But what if we picked up a second moon? Well, that seems like a different topic to speculate and investigate on DiscoverZen.